All right, so now that everything is set up, we can start with the exercise. As I said, we will be using Jupyter Notebooks specifically to build the neural network. I'll be using Keras in this exercise. You might have heard of it. It is basically a wrapper around the TensorFlow library. So I'm sure you have heard of TensorFlow. It is a more, let's say, advanced API or advanced library where you would need to do more of the things hands-on or decide things manually, whereas Keras is kind of like a higher level one where you don't need to go into the details of things. You can just complete or like build a neural network in just like one or two lines of code, whereas in TensorFlow you might need it to do it like, I don't know, maybe 10 lines of code. So it's kind of like a simplified version of TensorFlow, and we're building a simple neural network here, so you know, we don't have to use the all functionalities of TensorFlow. All right, so the first thing I do, of course, I import this. Once they are imported, my libraries are imported, next thing I want to do is load a dataset. So as you can see here, I'm loading a dataset directly from Keras. I'll just show you what other datasets there are. If you just Google Keras datasets, you'll find them. They have a bunch of simple built-in small datasets, as they mention it. The one we are using right now is the MNIST digital classification, a digits classification dataset. I'll show you what it looks like in a second, but it's basically handwritten digits. And looking at their images, we're going to try to understand with what number they are. Another one is the fashion MNIST dataset. On that one, you have little images of clothing items like coats, t-shirts, jeans, etc. And on top of that, you can build a neural network to predict or understand what clothing item that is and kind of label it accordingly. So as I said, we will be using this one today, but I would actually highly recommend you to do the exercise again using another one of these data sets. But be careful, some of these have, so the ones that we're working with are basically grayscale, so they only have black and white and grays in between. So they only have one layer, but some of the other ones are RGB photos, so they are colored. So then you have three layers of numbers. So that might be a little bit confusing. So I would actually suggest that you try the same exercise with the fashion MNIST dataset. But let's look, import our dataset first. How you do it is basically you just say Keras dataset MNIST, you kind of call the name or put the object into this variable, and then once you say load data, then you can load it. It's already divided into X train, Y train, and X test and Y test. You can see how to do it here actually. So basically what we're doing is we're doing it in two lines. So we are first importing the dataset, and then we say load data, and we load it into different variables, x test, etc. But yeah, you can do it in one line too. So if you want to import another library, you just need to basically follow whatever notation that they give you. So let's do that. All right, so let's see how big our training data set is. So it has 60,000 images, and they are 28 to 28 images. So as I mentioned, images consist of pixels, and all of these pixels has a certain value that determines how white or how black it should look. But we're going to look into it in more detail in a second. So I also want to see how many instances I have in my test set, and I have 10,000. So it's actually a lot of test cases, but that's how they divide it. So let's just go with it for now. And so this is what one example looks like. We have 28 length arrays. So all of these arrays have 28 numbers in them, and there are 28 of them. And as I said, for each of the pixels, we have a value. And these values go from 0 to 255. So the higher the number, the wider the pixel. So these pixels are super white. So of course we cannot see clearly what number this is now, but I'll show you in a second some examples. So here I'm basically just creating a figure and I am showing the image. So I'll show 9 images. So in a for loop, you know, I'm saying take 9 images and show it in a 3x3 matrix. So this is what it looks like. As I said, the brighter the pixel, it means that the higher the value of the pixel. So and this is, these are our handwritten digits, and we're going to try to understand if it's a 5, it's a 0, it's a 4. So of course a very simple task for a human, but it's going to, we're going to need to build a neural network for that. So the next thing that we want to do is actually normalize our values. So what we're going to do is, as I said, we have values, the pixel values go from 0 to 255. But we will learn more about this in the future, about normalization of the input. But when you have values that are very different from each other, so many of them are 0, and then all of a sudden you have 250s, 170s, etc., it's going to cause some unstabilizations in our neural network. It's going to make the network, it's going to make it harder for the network to learn. So that's why we're going to normalize them. And what that means is we're going to put all our inputs from a scale of 0 to 1. So how we're going to do it is basically we're going to divide all the values by 255. And at the end, effectively, all our values will be from 0 to 1. We're doing it only for the training data set. So what I do here first, I'm also creating a validation data set. So what we had directly from the data set when we imported from Keras is a training data set and a testing data set. So training data set is to train the model, as it's in the name. And the testing data set is to test the model. But we also need something called a validation data set. And what that one does is, you know, we're going to run the model, train the model on our data set a bunch of times. So we're going to show all the examples to the model, to the neural network. It's going to learn something, and then we're going to do it again, and we're going to do it again. So that is called epochs, or number of iterations, you can call it. And while you're doing it, you would also want to have some sort of an internal test data set, kind of, so that after every epoch, after it has seen all the examples, it can look at some examples that it has not seen yet. So while it's updating its values, it can generalize a little bit better, so then it does not overfit, we can say. So that's why I'm dividing the data set into validation and training data set here. I'm saying take the first 5,000 as validation data set, put it aside, and also divide it by 255, because as I've shown you here, we have values that go all the way up to 255. And we also want to take the rest and also divide it by 255. So I do the separation for validation and training, also for the also for the y values. So, but I don't need to divide them by anything because they only go from 0 to 9 and they do not actually have values that go all the way up to 255. And of course, I need to do the same thing for the testing data set because we want them to look the same. So let me do this. And the next thing that I want to do, or maybe I can show you before what it looks like after we divide it by 255. So if I take the same example here. Nope, this is not the full one. I need to, let's take a look at the validation one. Yes. So then you can see we have a lot of 000s, and then all of a sudden it's like 0.6, 0.7, 0.9. So that basically we achieved the effect that we wanted. The next thing that I want to do is to define the class names. So what I have here is I want to give a name for all the class names. What I want to do is basically give them a string value. Let's look at a test data set. It's already going to look like 1, 2, 7, 9, etc. So if it's 2, it means that the number or the image is 2. So that's good. But you know, if you use any other data set where you need to give names instead of the numbers, for example, the Fashion MNIST data set that you might want to try doing this exercise with, for that one, you're going to have to change these to whatever the names are. So it's probably like coat, t-shirt, jeans, boots, etc., etc. So for this one, it's not 100% necessary. I just wanted to show you how it's done. And yeah, I just wanted to make sure that everything is correct. So I'll just take a look at what the class name for the first training example is, or the second, because the first one would be 0. But let's look at this one. And I also want to look at the picture to see if it's correct. And yeah, it is correct. We didn't do any mistakes because I'm, you know, taking this 3 from here. Because if I, you know, if I just say why train, it will also give me 3. But what it does is basically it says, okay, this is tree, what is it, what in the string form. So if I had different names for it here, if it was like coat, jacket, jeans, boots, then it will show me boots here when I said this. And if I only said white train one, it would have only shown me three. All right, so this looks correct. Let's check it for something else. Let's say like eight, and also change this to eight. The eighth or the ninth thing, it's a nine. Okay, yeah, it is a nine. So, all right, it's correct. So this is how the data is imported and is done some quick transformations to fit in the neural network. And next we're going to look at how to build the neural network itself.